a few months, maybe since January, you've been trickling out some new products. Why the slow trickle? Is that sort of like news to come?
We've just kind of been active and wanted to share what we've been working on. Yeah, we put out three songs. First was Now's the Time and This World. And then we put out Restless a few weeks back.
By the way, I just want to give you a heads up. His socks. You're a Stance guy. You want to do a sock check? It's a Wu-Tang. Oh my God.
It's a Wu-Tang. He's got the Wu-Tang.
This is very uncomfortable. I wish I could show you my Wu-Tang underwear that I'm wearing right now. I mean, Wu-Tang Stance.
I'll take your word for it, yeah.
There's some time later for us. So Trevor and Tommy, you guys, you went to high school together or you just knew each other?
That's right, yeah.
So speaking of Wu-Tang, so Trevor and I, we've known each other for almost, 20 years now? And one day when we were living together, this is probably 10 years ago, I come in the house and he's working out, just singing Wu-Tang out of nowhere. I'm like, I had no idea you knew any of these lyrics or were a fan of this band.
Just bring the ruckus.
It's like, he goes, too high,
I wonder why.
And it auto-corrected to TWO. And I showed Trevor that in the green room in Asheville, North Carolina, the Orange Peel. He's like, oh, cool, like a peace sign. And then
he might be too high.
Anyway, I hadn't really thought of it like that, and I thought that was a cool concept. And the following day, we had a gig in South Bend at Notre Dame. And that was during the Women's March. So we were watching C-SPAN and all that, and you know, kept seeing this, and wrote some of the lyric that day, and I had some musical ideas that I wanted to incorporate.
And then the guitar part, I'm trying to think if Spencer had this as a music band.
It started out, I was kind of going for a Manu Chao vibe, so we kind of just had progression. And then Spencer and Soundcheck, well, what if it was a little more sexy and played?
Well, okay, hold on. One sec. Now, the James Bay chord, like this thing where you. That was really it back then.
We're in the technical wheel.
Yeah.
Anyway, so that came about, and then I think we were sitting around, which is kind of Manu Chao anyway. So it was still holding on to that original vision. And then, yeah, the lyrics sort of came together just thinking about the Women's March, and it's, you know, 175 million streams later, been a good song for us.
It had a longer bridge, like didn't we double the...
Yeah.
For a while.
Yeah. And a producer that didn't even work on the song that we did on our previous record heard the demo and said, great song, bridge is too long, cut that. Then we got ahead.
Wow. And then we ended up elongating the chorus at the end. So like the live version that you hear is not the studio version, but it's pretty close.
And by the way, that producer gets a little bit of credit. Does he get credit in the story?
I don't know.
That's enough for you.
Yeah.
We were going to play that last, but should we play it now since we've been talking about it?
Yeah. Probably.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it.
I would have mentioned it's a natural progression.
Thank you.
exactly what I was hoping for.
Yeah.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Just imagine that right now.
Yeah. I really appreciate you guys coming. I really appreciate you guys coming and being part of this. If you want to do one more?
Yeah, thank you guys for coming. Thanks very much.
appreciate you. You can listen back to it. We'll have it online at hits96.com or inputoutputlive for the next couple of days. Thank you for coming. Thank you, Songbirds, for having us. This is a very inspirational, amazing space. So bring as many people as you can and show it off, because it's truly a very, very special thing we have in town. So thank you guys so much.